In part 4 of our lesson on solving right triangles, you're going to learn how to solve word problems with right triangles in them. There's 3 basic steps for solving word problems that involve right triangles. First step is to draw a picture and label all the given information on it, and then look for the possibility of creating a right triangle somewhere within the diagram. Second, you'll use SohCahToa to solve the right triangle for any missing parts that are needed. And third, you'll write your answer in a complete sentence using proper English. Basically, whatever the format that a problem comes to you in, you're going to format your answer that way. So if a problem comes into you as a word problem, then your answer should be written using words in a sentence. Let's take a look at this first example problem. We're told that an observer stands 150 feet away from a building. So we know our first step is that we need to make a picture. So we can draw in our observer. And we know that the observer's distance from the building is 150 feet. So we can label that on there. Next, we're told his eye level is 6 feet above the ground. Now, his eye level, we're talking about a height, so we know that height is always going to be perpendicular to the ground, and we know that that distance there is 6 feet. We also know that the building will be perpendicular to the ground. We know that vertical lines are always perpendicular to horizontal lines. Next, we're told from his eye level, he measures the angle of elevation to the top of the building to be 53 degrees. Now, using your definition of angle of elevation, you know that the angle of elevation is always measured from the horizontal going up. So if we put in a horizontal line from his eye level where he's making the measurement, and we draw in the line connecting his eye level up to the top of the building, then we know that this angle right here is going to be 53 degrees. Now, we know that this is a horizontal dotted line. We know that it will be perpendicular to the vertical line, which is the side of the building, so we can go ahead and add that in our picture. And we can see we definitely have a right triangle in our picture that we're going to be able to solve. Now we want to try to find as many pieces of the right triangle as we can, and we know that the distance from the observer to the building is 150 feet. We can see that this shape right here is going to be a rectangle, and we know that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other in length, so we know that this dotted line is going to have a length of 150 feet. Now we know a length of a side in our triangle. Now we're being asked to find the height of the building, and it's important for you to notice that the height of the building is not in our triangle, but a portion of it is. So what we could find using our triangle is this distance. Maybe we'll call it X. And then once we know X, all we have to do is add it to this height right here, which we're going to know because we know in our rectangle, opposite sides are equal, So if this is 6 feet, then this is 6 feet. So then all we need to do here is solve for x. We do have a right triangle, and anytime you have a right triangle, you may use SohCahToa. Relative to the 53 degrees, we see that the dotted line is the adjacent leg. X is the opposite leg. So then that means we're going to be using the tangent function. So tangent of 53 degrees has to equal the opposite leg, which is x, divided by the adjacent leg, which is 150. We have to solve the equation for x. The only thing that has to move is this 150, which will cross multiply up. So the left-hand side becomes 150 times the tangent of 53 degrees, and that's going to equal x. And now we turn to our calculators to figure out what x is going to be. So we're going to take 150 times the tangent of 53, close your parentheses, hit enter, and because the problem asked us to round to the nearest foot, we're going to say that x is approximately equal to 199 feet. Now, to find the height of the building, we know we're going to have to add 6. So the height of the building is going to equal x plus 6, which is 199 plus 6, which is 205. And now we're ready to write our answer as a sentence. So we can say the height of the building is 205 feet. And that's all you have to do for your sentence. It doesn't have to be a big, long, complicated sentence, but it does need to have a subject and a verb and a predicate, and it has to have a capital letter and punctuation at the end. It has to be a proper sentence written in English. In this next example, we're given that a smaller building standing 30 feet tall is a short distance away from a taller building. So we can see we have a smaller building, we have a taller building, and we know the smaller building is 30 feet tall. So we know that height. We know that the sides of a building are vertical, so they will be perpendicular to the ground. We can put that in our picture. Same for this building. The vertical side of the building will be perpendicular to the ground. Next, we're given that two measurements are made from the top right corner of the smaller building. So we'll be making two measurements from this top right corner. The first is that the angle of elevation to the top left corner of the taller building is 32 degrees. Now we know that angle of elevation is from the horizontal going up. So we'll put in the line to the top of the building, and we know that the angle of elevation is going to be 32 degrees. Next, we're given that the angle of depression to the bottom left corner of the taller building is 19 degrees. So again, remember, the measurements are both made from this top right corner. Now this time, we're doing angle of depression, so we know that means we're going from the horizontal downward. So if we add in that line going to the lower left corner of the building, then we know that this angle is going to be 19 degrees. We're being asked to find the height of the taller building. So this is what we have to find. Now we know that the building is a rectangle, so we know if this side is 30, we also know this side is 30. We could have labeled it either place. The horizontal dotted line and the ground are going to be parallel to each other. We see we have perpendicular lines here, so we know this is a rectangle. We know that the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal to each other, so we know that this distance is also going to be 30. So if we want to find the height of the building, the only thing left to find then is this length. So let's call it X. And we can see that the height of the building will end up being X plus 30. Now remember, one of the things that you're always looking for is to find out if you have any right triangles. Now we know that the dotted line is horizontal and the side of the building is vertical, which tells us that those two lines are perpendicular to each other. So we know we have a right angle here in this triangle, and we have a right angle here in this triangle. Now I'm trying to find X, but in order to do that, I need to know a length of a side in this upper triangle. We can find the length of this dotted line by using the lower triangle here first. Then once we get the length of the dotted line, then we can use the dotted line's length and the angle of 32 to find X. So we should call this dotted line something. I guess we'll give it a variable name and we'll call it Y. So let's find letter Y first. We do have right triangles, and we know anytime that we have a right triangle, we are allowed to use SohCahToa. And now we'll analyze the parts that we have. We see that relative to the 19 degrees, the 30 is the opposite leg, and Y is the adjacent leg, so we're going to be using the tangent function. And we know that tangent of 19 degrees is going to have to equal the opposite leg, which is 30, divided by the adjacent leg, which is Y. We'll need to cross multiply the Y up to the left hand side, cross multiply down the tangent 19 to the right hand side, and we'll get Y is equal to 30 divided by the tangent of 19 degrees. And now we're ready to pick up our calculators and find out what Y is. So we'll enter 30 divided by the tangent of 19, close your parentheses, hit enter, and you see we get 87.126, etc. Now we're going to want to store that value to use it later on. So you hit the STO button, and then you see you have choices A, B, C, D, E that you can use your cursor keys to get under. Let's put it in A, and then hit Enter. Now that value is stored in memory location A so that we can use it later on to finish the problem. So we see that Y is approximately 87.126, whole bunch of decimal places. Now remember that what we just did was stored it in memory location A so that we can use it later. Now that we know what Y is, this 87.126, we can use this upper right triangle to solve for X. And relative to the 32 degree angle, Y is the adjacent leg, X is the opposite leg, so we'll be using tangent again, and we've got tangent of 32 degrees is equal to X divided by Y, which is the 87.126. We only need to cross multiply the 87.126 up to the left hand side, multiplied times tangent of 32 degrees, and that's going to equal X. So now we're ready to use our calculators to find the value. To get at that 87.126 we stored, we're going to use a key called memory variable. You see the MEMVAR key. Hit that. Make sure the cursor is under the A to get that 87.126 and hit enter. Then we're going to hit times, then the tangent key, 32, close your parentheses, and hit enter. We were asked to round the answer to the nearest foot. So then that means X is going to be approximately 54 feet. Now we're ready to find the height of the building. And we know that the height is going to equal X plus 30. So that's going to be 54 plus 30. Which is 84, and now we're ready to write our answer in a sentence. And we would say the height of the building is 84 feet.